Welcome students, class 6 students, you are newly entrant to our very very dear Vidyapeeth, and this Vidyapeeth is also very dear to you. But you know, due to this pandemic, COVID pandemic crisis, you have not availed this opportunity yourselves to be here. We are equally very sorry that despite our earnest endeavors, despite our best intentions, we have not been capable to bring you in our campus life. But we all members of the Vidyapeeth family, from high to even that very ground level worker, tried utmost to provide you the best, so that there will be no comparison or there will be no deficiency on our part to combat this crisis, this online mode. We have also launched, that is very most successful platform, RKMV, that is called Vidyapeeth Perfectize platform. And on this method, as well as these video lectures, we have tried utmost to give you the best. First, I would like to introduce myself, since you are the new one. Myself is Kanchan Banerjee sir, your respected as well as lovable KB sir, senior faculty member of English. My best wishes, my heartfelt blessings to you all, my loving namaskar to our respected parents. Today I like to start a chapter from the poem, that is, name of the book is Honeysuckle, and name of the chapter A House, A Home, a poem by Lorin M. Halley. And you know, this poem, this is the opening chapter of the book Honeysuckle, that I have already mentioned. Name of the book is Honeysuckle, name of the chapter A House, A Home, a poem by Lorin M. Halley. With regard to Lorin M. Halley, she is a poetess whose style is characterized by simple way of writings, but she is very much fond of writing simple things in a simple manner, but she tries to convey a message that how simplicity radiates or sparks a lot. First, I would like to make you aware of the basic points of this poem, that is, a house, a home, house, a home. Dear students, you might be knowing difference between house, a home. There is a marked difference between a house and a home. The poem points out that difference. The poem pinpoints that difference between a house and a home. And they differ in many ways. What is a house? House is a non-living structure, you know, made up of bricks, stones, woods, and in some cases, modernized house, you know, that house has had, that is called tile floors, yard, chimneys. These are the characteristics of the modern house. And these may have lots of doors, depending on requirement. And there are cement structures, but One basic thing, main essence of things which is present in home, that is not present in house, that is called sign of life. House is a lifeless structure, non-living entity. Unless the moment it is full of people, moment it there spreads, that is called sense of tenderness, affection, loving, care, concern, that very house becomes a home. That very house becomes a home. That's why I would say a house is a lifeless structure unless it is full of people. A home is a place where a family lives and with love and affections. A house, I have told you, becomes a home. House becomes a home. When parents, your loved ones, your near and dear ones, along with brothers, sisters, live together, living together, and care for each other, they are sensitive, they are emotional, they are ready to help each other. And you know, in the family of joint family, it is commonly available. Though in the present day context, we are now member of most cases nuclear family, but that home actually conveys the fragrance of such a caring, affectionate nature, tenderness. All these things are characteristics of home. The people living in home, at home, they understand each other well. They are ready to help, because they are in their ups and downs, even in well and woe. The family members work for the well-being and welfare of the family selflessly. There is no strain of selfishness. And if this selfishness is there, this is not called ideal home. Though in the present context it is happening, that is called selfishness, greediness, malice, all these are trying to overshadow or cover the feelings of an ideal home. But that is another matter. But the real definitions of home is as such. The home is full of such a sagacious people, selfless people, the tenderness, affection, caring for each other, fellow feelings. These all will be the common components. People living home, at home, they're kind towards each other, help each other in all ups and downs, well and woe. These are the common characteristics of home. And this is the basic difference between a house and home. A house, when it is transported to home, when these ties of the emotional values reside in that house, then this home will be considered, then this house will be considered as a place, and that will be as home. So this is the all about the samam bonam, a sum and substance of the very poem, A House, A Home. I repeat, just I like to differentiate between these two. What is house? House is a non-living structure made up of brick, stones, woods. It consists of windows and some cases in modernized house, tile floors, all these things are there. And a home is made by, that is, you know, loving and caring parents, your loved ones, brothers and sisters. It has family members who care for each other without any selfish motives. This is all about home. Now, I would like to explain stanza-wise meaning of the poem. Let me read out. What is a house? Stanza one. Stanza one, what is a house? That is explanations of the stanza one. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood, that's hard. Some window glass and perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. So here, regarding the rhyming scheme, you can identify in such a way. What is a house? Place. Just in the house, letter that is called letter A. If it rhymes with immediately, then it will be AA. But no, it does not rhyme with that. So, immediately after the first line, hard and yard, that means BB. Again, floors and doors. Continue, CC. So, ABBCC. First stanza rhyming scheme is as such. ABBCC. Now, meaning of the first stanza is very, very clear. There is no problem in understanding the first stanza. The poet has given a brief description about whom, about which, about a house. And mentioned, it is a lifeless structures, what I have told you. Lifeless structures, it consists of doors, windows and roof. A house is different from a home in many ways. The poet says that house is a non-living object or entity made up of bricks, stones, woods, glasses. It will probably have a small ground and a roof. Some house may have eaves. What do you mean by eaves? Let's see. Eaves means E-A-V-E-S. E-A-V-E-S. Part of a roof. The part of a roof. Eaves means. The eaves means that you know the meaning of this word eaves. That means the part of a roof. The part of a roof that meets or over changes the walls of a building. This word may be difficult in meaning for you, but I suppose now you have understood well the meaning of eaves. Yard means prangan, courtyard, angan, courtyard. And you know, lots means so many. Stucco means fine plaster used for coating or walls, surfaces or molding into architectural decorations. This first stanza, if some words are difficult, I have pointed out one that will be definitely stucco for stucco. Otherwise, other words are very, very easy to understand. And kindly means in a kind manner. Now, I proceed to the second stanza, that is the final stanza of this easy, very, very easy poem. What is a home? Now, I will proceed to defining home, because the poet's title is House a Home. If it is two parts, house that has been described in first part, now second part stanza two, what is a home? It's loving and family and doing for others. It's brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers. It's unselfish acts, kindly sharing. And showing means revealing your loved ones, you are always caring. So in this very stanza, the poet here defines a home which consists of family members What are your family members? Your brothers, your sisters, your fathers, your mothers, your cousins, cousin brothers, all are your family members. If you are a member of a joint family, all these are the component, essential components of your family. That is your home. Father, mother, sister, and brother. And they love and care for each other without any conditions, without any motives, without any selfish motive. They are unselfish. They are ready to help. They are ready to stand beside you. When you are in a depressed mood, they will be acting just like your most trusted friends you know. They are tender touch. Their loving care and concern would be considered to you a soothing balm. S-O-O-T-H-I-N-G, soothing balm. So that after getting cured, soothing balm, and you know such a care and concern that will revive you, that will make you boost up, which is readily available where? That is at home. They convert a house into home with their kindness, caring for each other. Without them, house cannot be called a home. So house being promoted to home, when these are all emotional values are readily available there, then we can say a house, a home. So house be home when these emotional values are there. The poet clearly defines a house and a home through this very, very simple poem. That means a house and home. And you know, some of the words like staccato, I have already written meaning of this. Caring, you know, loved ones, and showing, you know, revealing. So these are the basic things of the poem, sum and substance of the poem, that is house and home. Now, after finishing this poem, I would like to give you some assignments that will be done by you. Besides your chapter-wise questions, which are already there, just you note down some of the questions. One value-based question just I'd like to give you. Family plays an important role in a home. Family plays an important role in a home. Explain. With reference to the context of the poem, A House, A Home. This is an assignment meant for you, dear student. Take notes, jot it down. You have to maintain a copy for English. KB sir, MB sir, SP sir. KB sir, MB sir, SP sir. One copy that will be meant for us. Three teachers we have. That is Moinak Bandopadhyay, Kanchan Banerjee, Suman Paul. So for that question, family plays an important role. Family plays an important role. Important role in a home. In a home. Explain. With reference to the text, to the poem, A House, A Home. That's all. These questions. Second question. Differentiate between a house and home on the basis of the poem. Second question. Differentiate between a house and a home on the basis of the poem. These two questions, very, very important for you. Now, last questions, what is the basic idea of the poet? What is the basic idea of the poet? Last question, what is the basic idea of the poet? So I think there is no problem in understanding the poem. This poem is very easy to understand, and I have tried utmost to make you understand the poem. That's all about the poem. Okay, thank you again. Best of luck, best wishes to all of you. Thank you.